In this tutorial, we're going to talk about how to set up Google Analytics as well as Google Analytics dashboard within your installation of WordPress. But before I jump in, I just want you to know that if you're really taking growing your website traffic seriously, then you should know that we offer a suite of do-it-yourself SEO and website marketing tools to help you do things like increase your site traffic or rank higher in organic search for your desired search terms, find more leads, or get more backlinks to your site. So head over to atinyrhino.com once you're done this tutorial. So let's jump in. To begin, you'll need to get a free Google Analytics account. I'll provide a link in the description to the to Analytics for those of you who don't have an account yet. Once you have that account set up, you can get started. Simply head over to Plugins and then Add New. Search for Google Analytics, and then you'll see an option called Google Analytics Dashboard for WP. This one plugin both installs your tracking code on all the pages within your website, and it also provides handy back-end, as well as front-end, traffic monitoring tools such as charts and graphs. Begin by installing and activating the plugin. You will then see a link for Google Analytics in the admin sidebar. Click that and then General Settings. Here, you're going to want to authorize the plugin. You're going to be prompted for an access code. The easy way to do this is ensure that in another tab within the same browser, that you're logged in to your Google Analytics account. You can then click on Get Access Code. Follow the authorization steps. Once the process is complete, you'll be able to copy and paste the authorization code and save. Now, from the drop-down list, select the site that you want to monitor. You'll also be able to select your desired theme color here as well, and select if you want automatic updates on or off. Once you're done, click Save. Now, when you head back to your dashboard, you'll see Google Analytics shows up. Since I changed my theme color on the previous page, these charts might look a little different than what's in front of you right now. If you don't see Google Analytics data on this page, simply scroll down. It could be near the bottom of the page and require that you drag and drop it up a little higher. If you still can't find it, click on Screen Options and ensure Google Analytics Dashboard is selected. On the Dashboard page, you can select between different views as well as different metrics. For example, here we can search for pages. Here we can search for refers or organic traffic, locations, traffic details, or sessions. If you roll your mouse over any of the day's metrics, you'll be able to see more exact numbers. If you like, you can also monitor your real-time traffic, that is, people who are on your page at any given moment, by selecting real-time from the drop-down list. Now, you can also see your analytics on a page-by-page basis. Simply go to Posts or Pages and then click on the little analytics icon. A pop-up window showing data specific to that page will pop up. Again, you can filter based on time ranges as well as different metrics to analyze. To make sure that the software is set up to track all the pages within your WordPress website, so you don't have to add the tracking code manually to each page, simply go to Google Analytics and then Tracking Settings. If Tracking option is enabled, then the code will automatically be added to all the pages within your site. On the Backend Settings page, the Enable Switch View functionality allows you to switch between different websites that you're tracking in Google Analytics. Most people only want to track one website, so this can be switched off. But if you want easy access to other website data, you can turn this on. When you go back to your dashboard, you'll now see a drop-down list of different sites that you can monitor. Also, on the Backend Settings page, if you're not using the report on the Posts or Pages section of your site, you can disable that here by deselecting Enable Reports on Post List and Page List. Similarly, if you want to hide the report on your main dashboard page, you can also do that here. There is also a front end settings section here that allows you to add the report to your selected users in the front end. These usually show up near the end of a blog post, but depending on your theme, the report could also show up just above the blog post as well. For me, I usually keep this deactivated because I've found after experience using it slows down the load time of my front end pages for me as the admin, and I can get all of this data in the back end anyways. So that really concludes this tutorial. If you want your backend traffic numbers to be higher, then what I really recommend you do is head over to atinyrhino.com and take a look at our do-it-yourself SEO tools, specifically designed for WordPress webmasters. You'll see that we have keyword research tools to help you find organic search terms that are popular yet uncompetitive, allowing you to find low-hanging fruit, sort of quick win search terms. We also have rank tracking tools which chart your progress in organic search for your desired keywords and landing pages. We also have SEO audit tools that essentially read your website like a search engine would and provide a score for you, as well as easy and actionable steps to help that you can take to kind of increase that score. We also have backlink gathering tools, WordPress audit tools, and many more tools. So what I recommend you do is head over to atinyrhino.com and sign up for our 7-day free trial. Thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day.